fourth year in the airshow industry. As a matter of fact, when he was a youngster earning money to fly airplanes to take flying lessons, he delivered newspapers to the home of the Wright brothers. From the left, let's take a look as Bill Leff from Dayton, Ohio comes through in the North American AT-6 Texan, the advanced trainer. 5,500 pounds, 600 horsepower, and he does a beautiful roll on takeoff.
Thank you.
The airplane rolls over on its back. He'll bring it back around for the next part of his show. And I think we want to keep an eye on the landing here. Nearly 30 allied nations used variants of the Texan, built by North American engines, and then been free. Rolls the airplane upside down. Now look at the wheels. There they are. The wheels have just, when they went up, they went down. Well, I guess he extended the landing gear is what he did. Now Bill's going to slow the aircraft down now and show you how slow this airplane can go. Now we saw the FA-18 Hornet slow down. The Hornet was weighing in today, the Super Hornet I should say, was weighing in today about 40,000 pounds with an engine, combined engine thrust of 42,000 pounds. This engine generates 600 horsepower, but the aircraft weighs 5,500 pounds. So this, if he got going too slow, would drop out of the sky like a bag of hammers. But we're not going to see that with Bill Leff as he slows down to less than 100 miles per hour. Aerodynamically dirty with drag being generated by those landing gears, and also the openings also causing drag. Why don't you give a big hand to Bill Leff? It was indeed an institute of higher learning. There was a version of this that was used by the Royal Australian Air Force that had a different engine, a three-bladed propeller rather than a two-bladed propeller on those tails. Extended fuselage behind the cockpit, and they called it the Whirlwind. Became its own service on September, I believe, 18th of 1948. The primary trainer, PT, basic trainer, BT, and advanced trainer, AT designations were all scrapped, and all trainers were just T's after that. I believe the United States Army Air Force had over 10,300 of these aircraft built for them alone. Counting what the Navy used, or the Royal Air Force, or the Royal Canadian Air Force used. Bill goes into a four-point hesitation roll. In the beginning of the jet age, at the Korean conflict from 1950 to 1953, the fast-moving jets were having trouble spotting targets on the ground. So the Air Force took a bunch of T-6s and they re-outfitted them with white phosphorus rockets and put them in a combat role as a forward air controller. They would fly low over the battlefield, searching for targets of opportunity. When they saw one, they'd come back down, put some willy piece of white phosphorus rockets on the target, and mark the smoke. Dial in, those were the T-6Gs called Mosquito missions. As Bill Leff simulates a strafing pass. Thank you.
incredible pyro. All right, now I want you to get the cameras ready, because this is going to be a small wall of fire. We will see a huge wall of fire tonight. But let's watch as Bill comes in, diving on the target, and Rich's incredible pyro out there. The award-winning Rich Gibson and Dee Gibson and his crew of Killer Bees are setting up for a wall of fire. Here comes Bill Leff, and here comes the wall of fire. Bill Leff. Bill's going to come back in and do a victory roll. And then we're going to bring back our friend Kent Shockley to really get a contest going between Bill Leff and his Texan and Kent Shockley in the Shockwave Jet Truck. Because we'll see more of them as we go on, more from Rich's incredible pyro as our day goes on and our evening show goes on as well. Well, earlier we saw the Shockwave Jet Truck challenge, put out a challenge to do a race without any competition, reaching 347 miles per hour, according to what our air boss tells us. On a report from the Florida State Highway Patrol. But I want you to look out to your left, because very, very shortly we're going to see Kent Shockley coming back in that 7,000-pound free called the Shockwave Jet Truck. United States Air Force's F-15E Strike Eagle, flown by Major Mike Cash Mader and Captain Krista Kirtley, call sign Derby. Crystal, not Krista, Crystal, I'll get that right. Bill Leff's out there loitering a little bit. As we look at that Texan aircraft being flown by Bill Leff, 1939 was when the aircraft first flew, and it was being built for our own Air Force, but also for the Royal Canadian Air Force and the Royal Air Force, under the names I mentioned earlier, Harvard. And because the United States did not enter the war until December 8th of 1941, the day after the attack on Pearl Harbor, these aircraft had to be flown to the border of Canada. The engines had to be shut down and then pushed across the border, engines restarted and sent to their bases in Canada. Well, in Holton, Maine, customs officials from the United States and Canada got together, and when the planes landed, they politically moved the nose of the aircraft to the tail. They kept the bullets to their bases. Look to the left, ladies and gentlemen, here comes He's got 120 gallons of diesel fuel to power. The Batmobile's way down to the right. Kent will go to the start line. Bill Leff will then go out far to the right, reposition, and dive down on the starting line where Kent Shockley will be standing still, but will have his engine spooled up to maximum power. As Bill Leff goes by him, Kent's flagman will throw his arms down and throw the flag down, and we will have a race. How many of you think the airplane can win the race? Make some noise.
Sponsors, L3 Vertex Aerospace, proudly supporting naval aviation through aircraft maintenance and supply chain management right here at NAS Pensacola and NAS Whitehead. That's L3 Vertex Aerospace, world-class aviation maintenance and logistics services. FedEx is proud to participate in the 2010 Blue Angels Homecoming Air Show. Let FedEx solve all your shipping needs, overnight, ground, and even the heavy stuff. Grow your business with customized shipping solutions from FedEx. Relax, it's FedEx. Breitling has created precision timepieces for 125 years. Breitling instruments for professionals have a long history in the aviation world where accuracy, technical innovation, and reliability are critical. Dating back to 1950, when Gaston Breitling created the first wristwatch chronograph, which subsequently provided pilots with their first wrist instrument. Hertz Equipment Rental is a proud sponsor of the 2010 Blue Angels Homecoming Air Show. Whether you're a contractor or a do-it-yourselfer, from the smallest job to the biggest, Hertz Equipment Rental is the right place to visit.